Please like and subscribe to channel if you enjoy the video.
Why didn't I care that my husband cheated on me? I found out my husband was cheating on me in early 2020. I received an anonymous message which included a detail that only someone who knew my husband would know. I asked him about it and he trickle-truthed me, saying it was a one-time thing that happened in 2019. He asked me if I remembered the photos I found a year prior. He was referring to some sensitive pictures I'd found of him which revealed that he had a specific fetish he hid from me. I won't get into it because it feels too intimate to put online when the person in question is ashamed of it, even if it's anonymous. At the time, I, in all my naivete, assumed he had taken the photos just to do it, I guess. I think I suppressed the idea that he was sending those to anyone because he seemed so ashamed. I assumed he wouldn't want anyone to see them. It didn't occur to me that he might have an entirely separate, secret relationship with people online where he expressed himself in that way freely. When I found the photos, I forgave him for hiding it and reassured him that I loved him and accepted him. I asked only that he would be honest with me and trust that I would be there for him because those were the vows I made when we got married. At the end of that statement, I remember saying, verbatim, "If there's anything else you're hiding, please tell me, I won't be mad. I won't judge you. I just need to know. Because if I find out later and realize that you lied to me now, I cannot continue our marriage." He agreed and told me there was nothing else. I said I did remember, how could I forget? To which he replied that he had sent those photos to someone during an online sexual conversation. This person kept the photos, found my social media and blackmailed him, asking him for money in exchange for not outing him. He blocked them on everything, hoping they were bluffing, and then proceeded with our lives for a year before I received the message. My first realization through some of the things he said was that this person was another man. I asked outright and he said it was. I was surprised. My husband had never shown even an iota of interest in another guy. If he had, I wouldn't have cared and would have considered the possibility that he might need to explore his sexuality. I was open to it, but he never did, and so I assumed he was 100% heterosexual. The second realization was, it seems strange that, if it were a one-time encounter, why would that person wait an entire year to message me? I figured it was more likely that he had been doing this with various people and this one who blackmailed him was recent, or it was one person who he had been in a quasi-relationship with and my husband angered them in some way, so they snapped and finally sent me that message. I also didn't know if it was truly contained to online, so I made a point to get an STD test. I honestly didn't care if it was physical or only emotional beyond my own health concerns. Straying in real life or online was all the same to me. Aside from the surprise and sudden barrage of questions circulating in my head, I didn't feel anything. I peruse this sub often and read about betrayed spouses crumbling to the ground. I read of people crying and sinking into the dark bath of depression, asking others here how to crawl out. And believe me, I've definitely felt those emotions at times in my life. There were a few instances with my husband where I blew up, cried, wailed, shouted, etc. It hadn't been for a while, but nevertheless, I did feel things for him, or perhaps my own self-esteem. I say this all to mean I haven't always been devoid of emotion where he is concerned. Perhaps the most telling bit of information is that I could only think of one real, concrete thing when he told me, "I'm free now." We've been married for most of our 20s, and at least half of it involved me trying to suppress the needs I had that he absolutely refused to fulfill. I put up with his temper and his laziness. I put up with drinking and financial irresponsibility. I put up with, and loved him through, his extreme weight gain and self-imposed problems with his job. I put up with hygiene issues and selfishness in bed. I always wondered if I'd settled or if I should see it through, never arriving at a conclusion. Looking back on the moment, I knew that his confession was my ticket to get out without having to hem and haw over whether or not I was being unforgiving or unreasonable or too nitpicky. I don't believe you need a reason to leave a relationship if you're unhappy, but I do believe that you should fight for your marriage. It was hard for me to draw the line between what was considered working through the valleys of a marriage and what was putting up with bullshit that you shouldn't have to. That war raged in me for years. And still, despite the fact that this was pretty cut and dry, I found myself wondering if I could forgive him. Chalk it up to his intimacy issues and childhood trauma. After all, I wasn't really romantically devastated by this in a way that would have fueled an emotional decision one way or another. So I tried for a little while. I gave it a lot of effort. But he became paranoid about my fidelity and was constantly accusing me of cheating, checking up on me, and keeping tabs. Perhaps he was afraid of retaliation, I'm not sure. I put up with it, shocking for a while. We had many discussions where I felt nothing but pity for his clear shame and growing anger at his audacity as he spiraled into accusing me of outlandish acts of betrayal. I felt resentful in the sense that I had spent all these years trying to make our relationship happy and whole. I did the cooking and cleaning. I took care of him emotionally and sometimes physically, like when he got into a bad car accident and needed my help for months. I did the laundry. I took care of our animals. All the while, he was having late-night rendezvous just for the thrill and sexual satisfaction while I was asleep in our marital bed. And during my waking hours when he wasn't at work, he was gaming, snacking, and playing games on his phone. I realized that if I left, I wouldn't mourn him, but I would mourn my life. We were friends at the very least. Not enough for a married couple, but a lot for an introvert like me. I would miss the comfort of it terribly. I would hate telling my family, especially because I knew my sense of morality would disallow me from telling them exactly why I was leaving. And that meant it would look like I was leaving for some reasons I couldn't even articulate, painting me as a wishy-washy fair-weather wife. I resented my husband, but I nevertheless wasn't going to out him for his sexuality, whatever it may be. Fast forward a couple months. I had enough of the mindfuck that was our relationship at this point, and I couldn't deal with his explosive jealousy or the anger I felt. After yet another argument where I laid out my feelings and conditions and he looked at me, anger pulsing behind his eyes, and told me that I was callous and unfeeling, I told him I was leaving and we were separating. I told him I would look for an apartment and I was taking everything I wanted and needed. I did not want to stay in the home for various reasons, and I also secretly relished the idea of him having to take care of himself and the house and everything else in his life. I figured he would either see how arduous of a task it was, or he'd live in a filthy house, in filthy clothes, eating leftover takeout every day instead of the home-cooked meals he requested and that I made, which he loved. It was a petty win-win for me. When I left, it was emotional and uncomfortable, but I still didn't feel betrayed or broken by him. I felt immense sadness for how I was making my family feel. I felt terrible that I was uprooting my cats from the life they'd known. I was dreading the talks I have to have with my family and how it would surely make me cry when I looked at their pitying faces. I resented him and his s**t**y actions for putting me in this position. I probably hated him for making me shoulder this burden alone. My emotions were compounded by the fact that I was scared to start my life over and I didn't feel like I had the energy to go at it alone financially or emotionally. I did it anyway. I had all the hard talks with my friends and family. I worked more hours. I spent a lot of time with my cats and applying to second jobs. Through it all, I stayed fairly civil with my soon-to-be ex-husband. He took my leaving hard, but he knew he couldn't make me stay. He has never been very emotional, and the only time I got anything of substance out of him was when he would, most likely drunkenly, text me in the middle of the night with long drawn-out paragraphs telling me he didn't want to get a divorce. Why? Mostly ignored them. Eventually, he revealed to me that he had been cheating on me for over 3 years. That didn't surprise me though, because I think I knew deep down that something was amiss all along. I just didn't know what it was. This was all over a year ago now, and I'm faring much better. When I first left, I wondered when and if it would hit me. I wondered if it would dawn on me that I lost my husband, who I expected to spend the rest of my life with, that I lost what I thought would be my future, that someone who was supposed to love and cherish me took me for granted and betrayed me. But I don't feel that it ever did. I have adjusted well, as have my family and pets. I would say I'm pretty happy now, despite the divorce moving slowly for a number of reasons. It doesn't exactly plague me, but I often wonder why I never felt all the normal emotions when a betrayed spouse learns the truth. I never broke down really, and I worry that I have repressed the pain, whereas others were able to bring it to the forefront, feel all of it, and work through it in a healthy way. Giving such a detailed account as I did above is an attempt to let strangers in on the nuances of my relationship so that they can perhaps give some insight that I'm glossing over. In some ways, it feels like I answered my own question by revisiting the resentment that was festering long before I heard my husband tell me he'd been cheating on me. But it doesn't feel right. Could it be that I never truly loved him in a romantic way? Could it be that I sensed his dishonesty for a long time and put up a wall to protect myself? I'm curious if anyone can relate to me at all. Maybe make me feel not so alone. I wonder if he was right when he called me callous and unfeeling. I wonder now if something was wrong with me, or if something still is. Like I mentioned, this doesn't exactly plague me. I ask more out of curiosity and desire to discuss shared experience than anything. But any insight you have after this long read is very welcome. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the story, please like and subscribe to the channel.